Hi, this is Mark from LongIslandWatch.com. Always listening to the customer base. So when I released the field watch, that's the ISL 40, 41, 42, 43, a lot of you asked for a bracelet. I said I had no intention of making a bracelet for it. And then I went on to create the red dial 128, the day T, the 129. And then so many people started asking it, I figured, you know what, I better start making a bracelet. But when I went to go make it, I found out that, hey, since the cases came from different manufacturing batches and I was never gonna put them on a bracelet in the first place, the lug holes weren't tightly drilled enough for a solid end link bracelet. So I had to relent a bit and give the okay to manufacture a hollow end link bracelet. So that's the bracelet we're gonna see today, but it really elevates the watch. It fits the watch great. As part of this whole bracelet thing though, I went ahead and now have named the field watch. It is called the Mitchel. Named after Mitchel Field here on Long Island. It was a former airbase. So it's a cool name and it goes with my whole thing now of naming all the watches. So this is now the Mitchel Field Watch. This is we're gonna look at the BRAC 39, which is a bracelet that is specifically made for it. And you're gonna love it. It fits the watch perfectly. My own wrist check, I am wearing my Ulysse Nardin Maxi Marine Chronometer, all blue. This watch, I think, just recently celebrated its 10th birthday with me, so pretty impressive. And then on the other wrist, of course, I'm still sporting the Islander High Beat Northport. What a beautiful watch to get lost in the dial of. That's it. Let's check out this new must-have accessory for your Islander Mitchel. So this is the original Islander field watch. This is model number ISL 41. I've renamed them all the Mitchel, named after Mitchel Airfield. Here on Long Island, it was an airbase. So when I originally released these watches, I had them all on leather straps. And people started asking, not long after I introduced them, if it's possible to get them on a bracelet. And I'd already made a couple different runs. If you understand manufacturing, you'll know that if you're putting a strap on a watch, you don't need to drill the tolerances, the lug holes too tight if it's gonna be on a strap. But if you're on a solid end link bracelet, you gotta be a little bit tighter. So because I wanted to do a bracelet, but I'd already made too many batches and I want all the bracelets to be backwards compatible to originally sold Islanders, I had to have folded end links. That's the only, I guess, niggle about the bracelet that I have, is that it's folded end links, not solid. But I want you to know that it's folded out of necessity because I wanted backwards compatibility with all the Islander field watches out there. So I introduce we'll show it on a watch and on that watch in a second, on the BRAC. This is the BRAC 39. It's just like all my other bracelets. It's solid link. It is sized with screws, okay? It is a flip-lock, three-position micro-adjust clasp. Bop, bop. And it's hollow end links, as I just said. This is my first bracelet with hollow end links, but I think you'll find when you see it on the watch, it doesn't look bad at all. The weight on the bracelet is 71 grams versus a solid end link bracelet of the same size being 75 grams. So there really is not much in a weight difference. It is 175 millimeters from spring bar to spring bar. It's 20 millimeters to integrate with the watch. It is 16 millimeters at the clasp. So, ta-da. So this bracelet is going to fit all of your Mitchel field watches, which are your ISL ready 40, 41, 42, 43, 128, 129, that which is your day T watch. It'll even fit the DLC 82 and 83 if you want to put it on a DLC watch, but I'm only doing them in stainless steel right now. You are seeing some reflection off of a black curtain that's to my right, but this is fully stainless steel. I guess I'll brighten it up just a skirmidgeon. It looks really nice. Again, it is a hollow end link bracelet. I don't want people to think it's not, but it is. But it is, because it's hollow, it is also a negative or female end link. So it really bends in beautifully to your wrist. It's a very good fit, very good look. Price, $49. Most of my bracelets are $59. This guy's $49 because I went with the hollow end links. But this is it. Again, it'll fit all your Islander Mitchel field watches. It won't fit your AmeriQuartz ones. That was a different case entirely. It will fit all of your Mitchells. And again, the field watch is coming out in all different colors. The day T is coming out in different colors. I'll slap it on real quick so you guys can see it. And there it is. I have not sized it for my 6 3/4 inch wrist, but you can see I'll take out about 4 links on this guy. So it's going to fit up to roughly 7 3/4 inch wrist. And of course, as people know, if you need links, we can provide them. The links themselves are going to be the same links that are found on all of our 20 millimeter bracelets, whether it's a folded end link or solid. I always keep commonality on the links and just makes spare parts even easier. That's it though, right? It looks really nice, right? I'll throw up a photo as well because I have a model photo of the Day T with the bracelet, and you can see how it looks there. It looks really, really super nice. I can only imagine what the new varieties of Day T or how they're going to look on this new bracelet. And that's it. That's all we're going to do. This has been Mark from LongIslandWatch.com showing you the new Islander Mitchel Field Watch bracelet, an accessory you might need. Please like the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to the channel if you have not done so. Questions, comments, concerns, put them down below and I'll be sure to address them as soon as I can. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.